Hello YouTube. Today I'm going to show you how I was able to replace the polarizer filter on my 2005 SeaDoo GTX gauge cluster. This polarizer was damaged due to long-term sun exposure. To start off with, I simply removed all 10 of the screws holding the metal plates on the back of the gauge cluster. Removing these reveals four additional screws that hold the circuit board onto the plastic housing. After I removed those screws, I wasn't sure next where to go, so I started by removing this cover, and then proceeded to separate the clear plastic from the black housing. Instead of this, I would recommend to use a small saw blade like a Dremel here, make a cut at that seam. Then, after you're done, weld it back together with a plastic welder and some ABS rods. Not only was the method that I chose difficult, it also resulted in me cracking this clear plastic in two places. After I was finally able to separate the clear plastic, I found a second layer of plastic underneath. This layer of plastic was quite easy to remove with simply a small flat-headed screwdriver. If I had used the Dremel method, all of this would have come off as one piece, and I wouldn't have any cracks on that front plastic. Before you take the needles off, you should take a picture of where each one rests. That way, when you put them back, your gauges will be accurate for your tachometer and your speed. Now, my method of removing these needles was just to pry it off with a screwdriver. Unfortunately, it resulted in me breaking each of the needles, but they were easy to glue back together. Unfortunately, I wasn't filming when I actually pulled the needles off. Now, here's the fun part, removing the old polarizer. Simply use a new razor blade parallel to the glass and scrape the old one off. It will take quite a bit of time and maybe some glass cleaner to finally get the glass as clean as you need it to be to apply the new polarizer. Now, this is pretty much just like applying a screen protector on a phone. Make sure the glass is clean with no fuzz, no dust. Peel off the bottom layer of the polarizer. For this, I actually used a polarizer for an iPhone 5 LCD. After you adhere it to the screen, push all the bubbles out, and then take off that top layer protector that protects it from getting scratches as you're pushing the bubbles out. Now it's time to put the gauges back together. They actually snap on right around where the needle goes. I used a little bit of glue in addition to that to make sure that it doesn't peel around the edges. The needles themselves, just a little super glue did the trick. So put them back on. And also make sure that when you put them on, you do have them in the correct orientation that they were before, or else you will have a false reading on your speedometer or tachometer. Now for this, if you do the Dremel method, it will be a little bit different. There is a plug right there to attach the board itself to the plug behind on the back of the gauge assembly. And those four screws go on to hold the gauge to the housing. Now a little bit of cleanup. Make sure everything looks pristine, and also make sure you reset your needles to zero. To seal everything back up, I simply used a silicone adhesive all the way around the housing. Place that first plastic on after I cleaned it up really well. Now, even though I tried to use just a small bead, I ended up having too much adhesive and had to take it off and wipe off some of the extra adhesive. Now, the silicone is simply to keep water out. I used an epoxy for the outer glass. If you cut around the housing, then Harbor Freight sells a plastic welder in the neighborhood of $70 or $80. And then you can use some ABS plastic rods that you can find on Amazon for probably around $10. It is a little bit more expensive, but as you can see here, you won't have to deal with cracks in your front plastic. Now, after I put this on, I simply added some rubber bands to hold it in place while the epoxy cured, and that's it. Now I can easily read my display again, and it costs substantially less than the $800 the dealer quoted me for a new gauge cluster. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below. I'll do my best to answer it. See you guys.